so first of all, you know, thanks for coming. My goal is to make sure this is a rewarding experience for you, that you pick up something, at least
that you think about the art in a different way. We want to close our three days of kind of like day one, but when it comes to sequence, we're really talking about strategy.
Strategy, not so much tactics. So a tactic is a technique you use, but a strategy is how you use this technique, right? So, first off, let me talk about the primary central goal. I want to focus on one of the micro conditions of close guard. So if we think about our goal as to impose our will against resistance, we have to think, how do we give up an unfair advantage? And there are some like micro conditions that are naturally unfair for us at close guard. So the one we're talking about is the honor cost. Yeah, so please. I'm just going to review it, and then we're going to talk about how to get there different ways, and then we're going through a sequence.
So,
I'm in close guard.
If he has posture, you know, he's steady, like, this is neutral. Like, I have no innate advantage other than the fact that I have all my limbs and my hips to move. When I get the arm across and I lock him in position, now it's no longer fair. It's no longer neutral. I have an unfair advantage. And the question, the challenge for us is, how do we get there? That makes sense? So, first thing we're gonna focus on and drill is this methods of getting to the position against resistance. All right, so first situation we're dealing with is, you know, really old school, super old school. Like, you know, I don't even think it's common that much anymore, but some people still do it when they go double lapel. Grip. Good. One hand. So, hold. Yes. All right. Used to be super common. Used to be. All right. We're going to start off with doing this. Breaking the grip, dragging the arm, creating an ideal situation. That makes sense? So, you know, I'm also going to need a slight adjustment to common ways of breaking the grip. So, cross leaf. Common way is. Come in here, right? I switched it, you know, a few years back because I saw a better way of doing it that kind of flows naturally into both offensive, like, strings. Like, going here not only doesn't affect how I break the grip, but it also makes it easier for me to go overhook, and also it doesn't affect how I go sleeve drag as well. So here, by switching it here, when I pop my hip, lift the grip, I immediately can get into arm drag without much play, without much resistance. But the way we're going to use this grip break is to pass the arm across the center line. And to do that, I have to change something with my elbow point. So after the grip break, and the grip break is all hip. It's not just me like lifting. Even for like grip hard, it's me lifting my hip. And as I drop my hip, it's like a spring. Now, here's the detail that matters for, as far as like creating that situation we want to create for the whole class. My elbow opens, shifts. My knees come to my chest. So, start off, lift, break the grip, open elbow, and I'm rotating my hand to the other side of his wrist, and then I bring my knees to my chest as I punch down. So now when you try to square back up, really hard, and then I lock in the position. Does this make sense?
Yes, sir.
That's the first thing we drill. And then I'm gonna show you another method of getting to the same position. And then after we have that down, we're gonna start going into how do you take advantage of it into the sequence, the offensive string. All right? Yes. All right, pull away. Like, pull your arm, elbow back. Tug of war, come on. You know, if I'm pulling, he's pulling, man, it's who's stronger, right? But when I turn here and I push down, he tries to pull away. Like, I changed the mechanic by turning into a push. That makes sense? That's why after I lift, I'm turning. So it's like, break grip, shift, push, right? And just by changing that little adjust, that angle, and changing the mechanic of force, I get myself out of therapy. That makes sense? So what we're going to do is do it another way, because, like, man, you can't expect that someone's going to grab you like that, especially nowadays, because it's not as common as a grip that people play on top of the clothes guard. More likely, you know,
let go of it. So more likely, they might just posture it up, elbows in tight, you know, might even be grabbing the pants, whatever, and I still want to get them to the same position. That makes sense? So my challenge is, how do I get the arm across my center line if he has good posture and his elbows are back? All right? Now, I'm still going to go cross-sleeve. And the big thing here is hips. And I want to kind of use my hips. And it's like little rock. So like even if he's resisting, and it's gonna be faster. It's me lifting my hip, rocking. Make sense? And this is how we're gonna drill it. Like, you just partner has whatever grips he has, and what you're just working on is you're working on the adjustment of turning to a push, and at the same time, constantly moving his structure, his base. And ideally it should be super fast. Like, that make sense? Any question about this? All right, let's go into it. We're gonna play with that.
The person in the guard, are they maintaining grips or are they just controlling the head?
So right now,
For the purpose of the drill.
Person on the top is stable, like good posture. Good posture, you know, shoulders back, eyes looking forward, and they're trying to keep the elbows tight. They're kind of resisting slightly.
Okay.
You want to kind of simulate a real situation to the mm-hmm. best degree possible, mm-hmm. and get used to the fact that these rapid fire motions create little gaps in this control. And that control we take advantage of. Bah, boom, bah, boom, bah, boom, bah, boom. Until it's across. And it's like, bah. That makes sense?
Yes.
And we're going to drill this for a little longer. And then after this, we're going to go into our attacks. All right? 1, 2, 3.
And then we'll move on to the first attack. The one is, what do you do if the guy, grabs your belt instead? He's like anchored. And that belt grip is really strong because your belts are tied well.
This is when you can go back to that first option, the grip break. You know, if he grabs my belt and go cross-sleeve, look, if his elbow's down, I can't like slide under, I'm just gonna pop again. It's just hip. Like, my hip is gonna give me the space to get where I wanna be. And my hip is gonna give me the force to break. Make sense? All right. The other issue was, what if I go against someone so big that I can't lock up? You know, which it happens. Mm-hmm. You have your choice of not playing Clayton against him, but and ask, like, another option would be to pinch your knees. You know, and you can put the foot on the mat too, because now when you try to move, it still has the same control. And I can still lift my hip. You know, so since I don't have this anchor where I'm locking my ankles, and that allows me to lift my hip, it's really hard to do that without touching anything. So pushing my foot on the hip, I mean on the ground, I can lift now. So when I start trying to break 2-on-1, and then bring the knees to the chest. As soon as the hand starts going across the center line, you want to pull your knees to the chest. You know, we want to break the posture. It's like there are still some very basic principles in executive control playing close guard. No matter what we want to do, we want to break the posture. We want to destroy the structure. That makes sense? All right, so fun time.
Okay.
First attack. All right, so some people I know, you think, oh man, I'm going to go to the back. Go to the back. Go to the back. That is
It should be much later in the season. Like, it should not be the first half. Because there's so many offensive options on the way to the back that you should be throwing everything at it. That makes sense? So, first thing, like, boom, 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 boom. And yes, my hip moves out, but then it moves back in. So this hand comes in, grabs his lat, elbow comes down, it moves back in. And my elbow's tight, so he tries to, you know, escape. It's hard because I'm pulling his shoulder, I'm rotating his body. But I'm also square with him. Like, I move back in for a reason. I move back in so this arm would elevate. So look how far, some people can't see, but look how far his hand is away from the mat. My belly is on his elbow. I have him locked in his structure, and look, hand shoots in, catches. And I'm looking for his, wrist. Boom. And I lift my hip. And if I really want, I'm gonna go under his leg. Still there. I'm looking to trap an arm. And as I trap it, I just adjust until I can. But there's really no way for him to easily escape. So like when the arm comes across, I just dip. Hip moves out, hip moves back in. Depending on where his arm is, I can catch it here somehow. Sometimes I have to dig it in, and I can catch it here. Sometimes I have to hook, and I can catch it here. Sometimes I have to let go, and I can catch it here. But I'm throwing every attack at him. I'm trying to catch him short. I'm trying to catch him mid. I'm trying to catch him long. And I'm just like, pow, 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 until I get one. But it starts with elbow drop. That makes sense?
Mm-hmm.
All right, one more time.
So when you drill it, you can use any entry to the sleeve drag you want. So like, I might want to wait. And look, I'm going to try to catch him here, where I just, if his thumb pointing like here, I might not be able to catch him here. So I might want to go here, and then I'll still come. If I'm still not getting him, I might hook his thigh from over his shoulder. And he still tries to move. Like, he tries to pull away. Like, my elbow is trapping his wrist, and I just lift my head. And all of them possible. Just from trapping the wrist with my elbow. Does this make sense?
Sure.
And it starts off with getting the arm across. All right, ready? One, two, three. So we have the arm bar, right? And that was the progression that we can throw different variations of the attack in the sequence, depending on our attributes and depending on how well we work on each attack. Now, most people think, oh man, if I have to get the arm across, I'm immediately going to the back. But if you notice, when I do the arm bar, I square back up. I come back under the whip. Like, my hip was off to the side, and then it comes back under the guy. But at the same time, I'm shifting his body, so his shoulder rotates, right? So that's where his structure is damaged. In that moment, there's another attack, which I might be more inclined to use if maybe I don't like arm bars from bottom, or maybe the guy's super big. So, this is the second arc in the sequence. So same scenario where we're focused on our goal of getting arm across the center line, you know, however it happens, right? Right now, I just showed you two methods. So, pop, move in, grab the lat, move out first, and then come back. Right? So I have the arm bar. Maybe it's not working. Maybe I just don't want to try it. Of course, the secondary is basic. Pendulum, flower, it's there. And truthfully, I don't even have to hook away because it's so dominant. All I have to do is trap. I don't even have to do a lot of the traditional, like, hooking the leg, lifting the hips.
blowing them up. Why? Because I'm so dominant in that particular angle.
All right, break. Grab the lat. Move the hip out. Move it back in. And as I move, I'm bringing the elbow down. So he tries to move, he tries to resist. And truthfully, all I have to do is drop and lift this head.
Awesome. All right? And it's not really side dependent, like,
let's switch.
Let's see. It's a bit more. And, all right. You're about my size, right? I believe so. Close.
Break. Square back up. Look, my this arm is very significant. I'm not just loosely hanging on. I'm dropping the elbow and pulling his lat up. All right. Now, the sweep becomes better if I do it traditionally. If I hook the leg, swing the leg up.
It becomes better. Like, there's no reason not to do it traditionally. But there's no need to. Because of the dominance of the angle. That makes sense? So let me do it without tradition.
So just here, pulling a lat, block, there.
Okay? Number two.
Let's work. One, two, three.
So, I'm gonna show you something that is really, really, really powerful.
Right? This is something that I stole from one of my training partners, Richard Vermeer. She had this in her arsenal really early. Like, I remember one particular instance, like, she won worlds at blue belt just with this particular, like, grip and submission. Like, if she didn't finish them, she always took the back of them, right? But it flows off of creating this situation where arms cross the center line. Right? So connects. And sometimes it might make more sense than trying to sweep someone. It might make more sense than trying to armbar someone. Right? So I still break the grip. Shift. Knees come to chest. Right? Grab the rack. Hip moves out. And as hip comes back in, my elbow closes. Right? Now, to get to this attack, instead of moving my hip back in, I'm going to kick it out. That makes sense? So, the reason I review this is because I want you to understand it. Right now, we're taking that last piece out. So, now, I got to break the grip. Shift, bring the knee to the chest. Grab the lat. Move out. And I stay out, right? But I'm not taking it back. Instead, this hand, the free hand, the one that we're grabbing the lat, is gonna come over, grab the bottom side collar. So, can you look up? Now, let me show you how I'm gonna use it. So, grip break. Moves out, lock up again, shift, grip. All right, elbow down, foot on the hip, and then I bridge. Like I'm using this hip as an anchor, and my hip is going into the back of the shoulder. So like you can try to drive back into me. You can do whatever you want, but I'm going to get that choke or I'm going to take the back.
Can you turn that one on?
Huh?
Can you turn that one on? I just want to be choking.
Man, that's a true friend right there.
It's kind of.
So, break the grip, shift, and come down, punch down. Grab the lat, step out, sit, scratch. Elbow drop the knee. So you open elbow, he's going to run back down. So, as soon as I get the grip, and look, my hip starts going in, getting the hip. And look, I'm just going to drive my hip into it. I'm not really like a pulling. It's all about no arm strength. That makes sense?
Yep.
It's all hip dominant. All right, let's play with it. One, two, three.
So, now let's troubleshoot. So, of course, the challenge is I want to get the arm across. He does not want me to get the arm across. All right? And he will either pull high, like he'll pull away high, or he'll pull away low. Does that make sense?
Yep.
I have answers for both situations. All right? We're going to talk about what happens if he beats me on a transition, like because I was a threat and pulls high. Like he just rips the arm back. Right? And I'm not able to get it across.
So, again, we're just going to stay with the grip breaking scenario. So, it's only a little easier to focus on that. So, I break. And as I'm switching, he starts pulling away high. Alright? I feel him resisting. And this is something I have to work on as far as my timing. But as soon as I feel him start pulling away, my goal is to let him pull me up. Alright? So like his now I broke the grip. Boom. And I start turning. He pulls away, I let him pull me up. And I come all the way to him. Like I want him to pull away hard. Like, so I want my threat to be so significant he has to react strongly. Like so, man, I've done this to him, you know, so many times and he starts to be really resistant. And that's what I want. I want to lift that hand to the sky. I want a base on the back of my hand, but not elbow, not shoulder. Hand. Make sense?
Yeah.
Why? Because I'm just gonna do a hip bone. Right? If I do a hip bone, I have to have structure. I have to have base. You know, so now I'm going to try to put the glute back into him. Put the leg back, look away, and then look. I'm going to treat this hand, this grip, like a sword. And my hip is a sheath. Like I'm sheathing it. Put my sword back into this and sheath this. I'm still ready. All right? So I'll look away, lift my hip. I sweep. Now? And it flows off of his logical response. Like his logical response is to pull away. And he either pulls high or he pulls low. Like, and I should have answers for both. So, again, break the grip. Next start turning, he pulls away. I'm gonna pull me up. And then I punch to the side, play the foot, look away. Again, it's basic, right? We're just giving it context, purpose, strategy. All right, let's work. One, two, three.
Like, someone pulls away, they try to put their elbow on your hip, and like, tight, right?
We still have an answer.
So, pull guard. He has grip. Yeah.
Oh, well, I'll explain this later. So, hot. And then he just, before I'm able to transition, he pulls his elbow to my hip. You know, like real low. And now I try to pull out, and he's like clenching it to my hip. So it's really no hard, it's hard for me to bring down my hip. Now, I still have my first, you know, my secondary transition. Like the 2-on-1 hip bump. I have that, but I'm gonna redo that real quick and I'm gonna show you the secondary option, the submission of that. So like, I can still go 2-on-1. Bump, 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 and get across. Like, it still will flow for my two transitions to arm across. But, here's the last option or last initiative of the series. I break the grip, he pulls low and tries to hug. Now, one thing that happens when he does that, his posture comes down. Right? And what I want to do is I want to help him maintain his structure. So I'm going to switch my grip. And then thumb in the collar, pull down. So now I'm gonna try to pop you away. And I'm constantly I'm pushing it with my left hand. I'm pushing his hand into his stomach. That makes sense? Okay.
It seems like I have stuff, but really he's stuck. Because I still have enough grips. But like, he tried to toss you away. Hard. Trolling thing. And look, all I want to do is start rocking. So what I'm going to do is, look, this leg. Hit. 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 Well, like, when I do it, it should be a fast lock. Third break. He pulled away. Switch. Like, you can even grab the back of the anything to hold him down. So when he tries to push away, it's hard. And then I'm just rocking. That's the rock. It's like back and forth until my leg can open over the other. So it's like here. Like, do it slow, but like in reality, it should be fast. It's like a, you're just rocking them in the boat. Does this make sense? Any questions about this? All right, let's try it. 1, 2, 3. Just focus on one thing. Like, just take away one thing, it's a success, right? All right, and I'm glad you all came out. Of course, I hope you learned something. You can feel free to ask me any questions, like they weren't clear. I know I had some questions about why I grip like this as opposed to this on the gripper. And the reason is, it's not because of this series, it's because of the open series. I'll just do that real quick before closing out. So when I do this grip break, most of the time it's one or two options for me. I either sleeve drag or overhook, right? And I want the option to make the choice at the moment. So, like if I grip here and I break this grip, right away I can shoot this hand through and wrap around and then go into whatever I want to do here. But if I grip traditional and I break the grip the same way, now I can't just shoot through, I have to circle in. And that makes it a little more inefficient. So that's why I'm gripping that way. All right, so hopefully that's helpful too. All right, so officially it's 6 o'clock. Open mat started, but I would like your assistance for a moment because like I want to do something special, and I don't know if it's gonna be much of a surprise, but I have a student who's been coming to this camp for 4 years, all right, and he's still a white belt. He only recently started training with me. But he's been coming to this camp for so long, and he loved it so much that I decided to promote him here.
Bruce.
And he happens to be here. He's kind of hiding. Come on, Zach.
Comments on the fact that he's still a white belt, because when you roll with him, it doesn't feel like it. And he's been training for, man, what, 5 years, 6 years? A long time, you know? But life. He didn't train much last year. But it's time.
Yes.
Go up. To the next level.